into the locker room as the players get set for the game ahead, looking to make a big splash here tonight. Illuminating the landscape, Sears Tower and the rest of the Chicago skyline as night falls upon us. Welcome to 2K Sports. We have the NBA coming up. Great to have you with us. Alongside Hall of Famers Doris Burke and Grant Alley, take it away.
Hey, Brian, the Chicago Bulls.
All right, thanks, Alley. So here's the Clippers starting group. And for Chicago, and Grant, no shortage of athleticism on display tonight. Something you'd know a little bit about.
Well, you know, B.A., in my younger days, I might have caught a few guys, but maybe we'll see a few highlights tonight, too.
And it's going to be the Bulls off the tip. Out left to the wing. Fires the three. Hits the trifecta.
And that's what they want to do. Get him open looks early.
To the paint. Nice start for him. Sinking his first shot.
Just taking it right to the rim. And no one was there to greet him.
And I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
Sinks it from distance.
Well, that possession to me highlights the importance of creating for your teammates.
Yep, that one goes.
Oh, nice feed. On time and on target.
Chicago has gone 2 for 2 from deep to start this one. Rebound by the Clippers. And just over a minute played here to start the game. Oh, a nice one-handed slam right there.
B.A., when he gets the rim in his sights, it's tough to stop.
So aggressive and a determined finisher. Nice. And the layup is good.
You know, outstanding start. You've made 3 of your first 4.
The Clippers have gone 3 of 3 out of the gate. And in the first, a little over a minute and a half in. Can't cash it in from close range. To the middle. Picked it out of midair. And that one makes him 2 for 2. He's in his rhythm.
80% from the field to start, playing with a ton of confidence.
From deep. The offensive rebound. The layup misses. The Clippers have gone 4 of 5 so far, looking sharp. They now take the lead. 7 points in the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches might let you hear it for taking the three-pointer on the break, but I like the decision there. The D had already collapsed inside.
That one from long range. The Clippers have gone 5 of 6. They're rolling. Again, it's the Clippers converting.
Now you want to get him going as soon as possible. Great way for him to start this game.
He's a guy who, if he gets hot, he can carry your offense for long stretches.
Number 7.
About 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. You got it. Here he goes. It's good.
And defensively, you have to make him work harder than this, or it's going to be a long night.
And he buries his first look. The Clippers have got 7 of 8 in the basket. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in this first quarter. The Bulls have gone 6 of 9 and finding their rhythm now. And again, it's the Bulls from deep.
Well, the versatility he possesses makes him a very tough cover, guys.
The Clippers trail. No good there. So the Bulls will take it the other way. A quick quick shot there. It's off target.
2 minutes remaining in the first. 2 minutes.
1:58 left in the first. Another miss. He's 2 for 4. That one falls.
11.
And they may have talked about shot selection coming into this.
Number 10.
And there's 1:45 left to play in the first quarter. Can they get it? And close on the shot, even with the foul. Now 2 free throws.
I don't mind that. I mean, they met him at the rim and temporarily prevented the points.
So he gets them both. 1:35 left in the first quarter. From deep three-point range, from beyond the arc, and then some.
And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
1:25 left now in the first quarter. Down low. Hits that one. Nice pass leading him to the bucket.
Good execution. They're getting some short-range looks here.
And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Getting out to a nice lead. Great flow and great execution.
One minute left in the first quarter here. Inside. And he floats it in for the easy two. Credit the sweet setup on that one.
And both teams already firing on all cylinders.
Yeah, this is already a high-scoring game, but we knew that was a possibility coming into this one.
Connects from downtown.
Oh, it's just raining threes for them early.
There's 37 seconds left in the first quarter. Blocked! Second chance effort. To the wing on the left. And the jumper from the wing offline. And for the Clippers, they're shooting a phenomenal 60% on the first. And he lays it up and in. He has 6.
I love the throwback basketball. Work it down low and set up your teammate.
Offensive rebound. Count that bucket.
You have to appreciate the doggedness and intensity on the glass. Wow.
With 1 on the clock. A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through 1. It's the Bulls. They're up 7. Let's take a quick break. For the Bulls. And here are the Clippers now. 7-point differential. He's now 1 for 2 with that bucket.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations, getting good looks inside throughout the half.
And for the Clippers. And a miss there on the triple. Well, the Clippers shooting 61% for the game, knocking them down. It's hauled in by the Bulls. Three-pointer. No good on the shot. Takes it inside, and it's good. 2 points.
That's 10 straight points they've given up in the painted area.
Chicago has gotten 6 of 10 three-pointers to drop. Oh, and makes it with the kiss. And Chicago leads by 5.
Always helps to get these kinds of looks, right? Super easy to convert from that distance.
The Clippers have got 2 of 3 shots to go in the second. Rejected. And it's out of bounds. The Clippers able to retain possession here. Both teams deciding to change it up. And the Clippers with the ball. Just 4 to shoot. Uses the glass to finish the layup. 6 points for him.
They're playing great team basketball. It's good movement and sharp, crisp passing.
Oh, he tries a three. Out of bounds. It'll be the Clippers' ball. So it's both teams making substitutions here.
Clippers substitution.
Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line. Brad, your dad played pro football. You think that players who grew up around pro sports have an advantage?
Yes, B.A. Obviously, being around a professional athlete, understanding the dedication, the sacrifice, the work that goes into it, really, I think, helped me at an early age as I was developing in a different sport.
Let's go with a three. The shot won't fall, and the Clippers will go the other way with it. In transition, here come the Clippers. And that misses. That would have put them up. The Bulls have gotten nothing to go out of five attempts so far this quarter. Lays it up and banks it in.
This run has been fueled by their matador defense.
From deep. Sinks it. What range from downtown.
Such a reliable threat from range. You think the defense might key on him a little bit more.
And here in the second quarter of action, just a hair under 2.5 minutes played. And he drives in. And that one is stuffed right through.
I just love the aggressive finish.
Now I'm thinking he's sending a strong message with that jam. Pulls it from the corner, and it's good. Off the back of the rim and in. And Chicago leads by two.
Well, this guy has been efficient and effective all night. That IQ has been on display.
Knocked away. Floats one. Count it. One for one to start the game.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
Timeout called. The Bulls. Chicago has gone 7 of 13 from downtown so far in this game. And they get it back. Another shot. The Bulls with another miss. The Clippers have gotten 6 of 9 attempts to go in the second. Looking good.
Number 14.
His shot was hindered by that momentous mobile one block.
Oh, terrific defensive intensity right there. Getting stops like that is crucial for them right now.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Just three to shoot. The Clippers got to hurry. Late clock here. Off target with the open look. The Bulls have gotten only 3 of 9 attempts to fall in the second. Launches it. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. Counted number from five. Distance. And now a 3-point Clipper lead.
This is as pure a shooter as there is. You've got to stay connected or it's a problem.
They grab their own miss. 2 points. That one goes.
You're fighting to keep the possession alive, something this guy does so well.
Out to the wing. Inside the arc. The shot off that time. So the Bulls will take it the other way. Wasted no time with that shot, but it's off the mark. To the inside. And he takes the feet in stride and slams it home.
Oh, what ferocity on the throwdown. I just love when he goes up with purpose.
Where was the D right there? The effort lacking big time.
Yeah, give him credit for taking advantage in a close game. Those are the types of plays that can swing things in your direction.
The Clippers have gotten 8 of 13 shots to fall in the second quarter. Cut comes up empty down low. Chicago trailing here. 43 seconds left in the second quarter. Sends it home from three-point land. He's got 11.
He nailed two from distance in the opening period. Now gets this one.
There's 37 seconds left in the second. To the middle. Drains it. Now he's 3 for 5.
And now almost all their points coming from the paint.
To the left wing. And again, it's Chicago.
Scoring well this quarter. Picking up steam as he goes.
We've got 22 seconds left in the second quarter. There's the drop.
Oh! I can't believe he just did that. Now that is incredible. Just wow.
From 13. No good. A bit long that time.
Taker, big shot maker.
Woo!
And we're through the first.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody, welcome back from the first half. The first quarter didn't play out the way the Clippers had hoped. A big part of the problem was their defense, an inability to slow down. And that's a.
Los Angeles has gone 3 of 5 from the perimeter in this game. Uneasy two on the layup.
Time and time again, they're creating good looks from close range.
The Bulls shooting 54% from the field so far in this one. And for the Clippers. Second chance shot. There's the block. Right wing. And there's a 3 second violation. And we've got to see that sensational mobile one block again.
Yeah, just some terrific effort there. And you know, the whole team will get an energy boost off a block like that one.
Can't get it to fall.
Boy, that makes them 0 for 3 to start the second half. Not the start you were hoping for here.
And they're building on their lead, doing whatever they can to blow this game open.
One of the things they're doing is identifying favorable matchups and then going at them.
Second shot opportunity. And it's blocked. And they'll keep possession. It's good. The Clippers in the lead.
Bulls foul, number 7. That's his first personal foul. First team foul.
Third quarter of basketball. We're about a minute and a half in. Ooh, what a play. Just palms the block. Here's the three. And it's the Clippers with the rebound.
Oh, man, he can't get anything to fall. You can feel his frustration.
He is trying to shoot his way out of it, and it might be better for him to pass the basketball at this point.
He really gets in perfect position for the follow. Just a terrific read.
Puts up a three. That shot off. And it's the Clippers taking it the other way. To the left side wing. Down low. Inside. And it's off the back of the rim. No good. Chicago has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. three. Good. 5 for 9 shooting so far.
Have to love the ball distribution. Keep everyone involved.
Timeout called. The Clippers.
And now that they have some time to get a little bit of rest, it's time for these players to regroup while hydrating themselves with some Gatorade, looking to gain a boost of energy as they continue to play in this game.
And staying hydrated is the only surefire way to do it. An athlete's body doesn't have the same power and stamina without proper hydration. These guys will be sure to use this timeout wisely.
To shoot. Oh, he goes up high for the two-handed slam.
And a solid pick to free him up for the dunk.
Boy, the timing there couldn't be any better.
The execution was simply flawless. That, ladies and gentlemen, is how you run that play. He's done a dynamite job rebounding the basketball and no issues fighting it out against the big guys down low.
Woo! His energy is unmatched.
The finish and transition, nice and easy.
Fires from deep. Hits a three-pointer. He has 6.
Lackluster defense, showing no desire to chase shooters off that line.
The Clippers have gotten 5 of 8 shots to go in the third. The three ball. Oh, and another 3 for the Clippers.
For 3.
Yeah, he's in his bag from beyond the arc right now. You see his confidence.
And I think the defender knows once he gets cooking, look out. The bucket looks awfully big to him right now.
Good decision making. Scopes the situation, puts the pass right on the mark.
The Clippers have gone 6 for 9 in the half. To the paint. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
Woo. Defensively, you can't afford to let him get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
I'll tell you, you can't get stops if you're unwilling to put in the work.
The Clippers have gone 7 of 10 here in the second half.
Chicago foul. Number 7. That's his second personal foul. Second team foul.
.146 left in the third quarter. Down low. Ooh, now 7 for 9 after that make.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
Chicago has gone 2 for 5 from 3 since halftime. From deep 3-point range. That one doesn't drop. Los Angeles has gone 4 of 6 from 3-point range thus far. Off target. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. Chicago trailing here. On the take. Goes up and lays it in, nice and easy.
Well, exposing a weakness in the defense, that's just way too easy, guys.
There's 1:12 left to play in the third quarter of basketball. To the middle. Nice dish, and the layup goes down. And Los Angeles leads by 8.
Defensively, they've got to get more bodies in the paint. That's 3 straight field goals from below the free throw line.
The 3. Bucket again. 7 for 12 and going at the defense.
Boy, picking up where he left off. His second from distance this half. 5 overall.
50 seconds left in the third. Goes back up. And he lays it up and in. Give him 8 points now.
Looks like we're starting to see a pattern here. Not afraid to get in the paint and get wet.
The baseline, Jay. And the rebound paying off as they pick up 2 on the second chance bucket right there.
When it's this close, every bucket matters. You need good looks.
Unloads from 13. And again, it's the Clippers.
Assisted by.
He's putting them to the test this quarter, attacking every chance he gets.
Over to the left wing. Fires for 3. They get the rebound. Tries again. Oh, he got him with a pump fake, but he couldn't finish. That shot is off. And that's it for the third quarter. Both teams scoring well as we head to the fourth. Clippers ahead, leading by 7.
Don't go away. We'll be back momentarily. And so here is Chicago. For three. Nice shot there, making him 8 for 13.
They are unconscious from outside. And so far, the defense has had no answer.
Well, that's the whole point, isn't it? If you space the floor well enough, it's almost impossible for the defense to account for everyone.
And for the Clippers.
Chicago foul. Number five. That's his first personal foul. First team foul.
Out to the right wing. Can't connect from 13 feet out. Fires the three. It's not going to go for him. The Clippers in the lead. And it's the Clippers on the break. Driving inside. Ducks it hard with one hand. Wow, he makes it look easy.
Oh, nice one-handed jam there, B.A.
Hey, little exclamation point. From 11 feet away, and it's the Clippers with the rebound.
I'll tell you, this guy is doing absolutely everything he can to get himself going, but the team is struggling because he's struggling.
They're just taking what the defense gives them, and right now, that's the interior.
The three. It from three. Give him 23.
And the defense is really allowing them too much room on the perimeter.
To the right side.
And he lobs it up top. And the lead increases on a crazy offensive sequence.
Man, the dunk alone would have been incredible, let alone the fact that it came off a pinpoint pass. And the bucket is good.
This is when your interior D has to be on high alert.
Moving along, 2 minutes gone in the fourth. Clock at six. Another three for the Clippers.
And trying to put the game away, he's been nailed all evening.
And he hasn't forced much tonight. I love the efficiency he's giving to them.
Oh, wasted no time on that one.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. Four of the last five buckets have been threes.
Over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. To the inside. Count that one. He's now 5 for 8.
They've been a little soft with their defense on the interior.
The Bulls have gotten 4 shots out of 6 attempts to drop so far in the fourth. There's the triple. James.
Well, individually, he is doing everything he can in this 12-minute session, but he's just not getting enough help.
The Clippers have gotten 5 of 6 shots to go in the fourth.
Bulls foul. Number 5. That's his second personal foul, second team foul. Coming onto the floor for your Bulls, number 7.
Out to the wing, lets it fly, and yes, number it goes. Five. Got a little English on that one.
And an number excellent 13. Job distributing the ball tonight. You can really see his feel for the game.
And that's been his role pretty much from the opening tip. Get the ball to guys where they can score it.
They're going at it on offense. Neither team backing down.
I'll tell you, we have seen great execution from both teams. Neither one giving an inch here.
Inside. And he converts the layup. And Los Angeles leads by 6.
Well, use the pick and going right to the cup. I love the aggressiveness.
Let's it go from deep. Fires in the triple. He's got 32 points.
A huge shot. His three-point shooting has been outstanding tonight.
Yeah, he's done more work outside the arc than inside, and that's not going to change now. They'll ride his long-range game all the way to the end of this
one. Number seven. That's his third personal foul. 13 foul.
Left in the final quarter.
That's about reading the floor. Hits his man right where he wanted
it.
The Bulls have gotten 7 of 9 from the floor in this fourth. Second chance effort. And it's good on the layup. And that's a double-double for him now.
And you can tell by how hard he battled for that putback that he still has a lot of energy left for the end of this game.
And doing that kind of dirty work down low makes a huge difference in a game this close. Offensive glass.
Such confidence as a passer. He hits guys in stride and makes it look easy.
There's the three. And again, it's Chicago with a three.
He's such a clutch shooter. This guy lives for these kinds of moments and delivers.
Los Angeles has got 5 of 7 threes to drop here tonight. Shot from 12. Clippers again with a bucket.
They ran that set to perfection and got a terrific look out of it.
Chicago trailing here. Second shot opportunity. And yep, that's going to be a flagrant one. Unnecessary contact.
At the line.
Ooh,
for Chicago.
Hard foul. Can't let him get away with that level of contact.
That's a simple call for the officials to make. Everyone knows the league is cracking down on that kind of intimidation tactic. And no luck at the stripe this time. Second one won't fall. 1:09 left in the fourth. Jacks up a three. He buries it from three.
Coming down the stretch, they've leaned on the perimeter game.
Boy, the three-point arc has been a major factor in what they've done here tonight. You love the aggressiveness.
To the paint. He was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
And you have to try to make something happen. I mean, they have to be aggressive at this point, even if it's risking a foul.
And he does get the second one, and that'll put him up 2.
And right about now, at this point in the game, there can be a massive difference between a 2- and 3-point advantage.
To take the lead. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. 2 points here could be the only cushion they need, Grant.
Hard to say. Crazier things have happened in this league.
9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock.
They can't go empty on any of their possessions from here on out.
No time to waste. Not at this point in the game.
Connects again from distance. Buries his 10th triple of the game.
Unbelievable, B.A. Unbelievable.
Now a timeout called by the Clippers. They're behind by 1. We've got 22 seconds left in the fourth quarter. All right, guys, what's your take?
This is where your coaching is so important. They need a really good play now.
He told them, quote, it all comes down to the next few minutes. That's what will decide this game. So step up. This is your moment, not theirs. Inspiring words, guys.
Okay, good stuff. Thank you, Allie.
Boy, that's the last thing they needed. This game too close to be making those kinds of errors.
There's 21 seconds left to play in the fourth. And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those, so they get into the penalty.
Yeah, just trying to keep this game alive. Not a bad foul right there.
And now they decide to foul intentionally.
That's his first personal foul.
First free throw is good. And that'll put him up 2.
As the one for the Bulls, number 7, taking 2 shots.
Second one is good, getting both at the line, and it's a 3-point game.
That last free throw was a huge, huge shot. The difference between a 2- and a 3-point lead at this stage is major.
The Clippers call timeout. They're trailing by 3. 19 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, your thoughts?
Tricky situation here. They need some kind of bucket to stay alive.
And it's either got to be a 3-pointer or score quickly and take the foul.
Big-time shot, sending his teammates into a frenzy.
I'll tell you, these guys have worked so hard together. Everyone.
shoots it. No good. To win the game.
Oh,
it's good. He hit it.
Great shot. The winner at the buzzer. It doesn't get any better.
You couldn't dream of a more dramatic finish. 3 points right as the buzzer sounds. This is a ball game people will be talking about for quite some time.
So it's the Clippers taking the W in a close one. With the late victory, they upset plenty of these hometown fans.
They really should take this win to heart. When the pressure was on, they stepped up and worked twice as hard to overcome it.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Doris Burke, Allie LaForce, and Grant Hill, and all of our crew, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. We'll see you later.